And now we're going to learn about how to record making mortgage payments. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. What does each monthly mortgage payment have? Well, each payment has a small amount for interest expense, which is the service fee that the bank keeps because they loan you money for the mortgage. It has an amount that decreases the principal balance, and that amount is going to be different for each monthly payment. And of course, very often, mortgage payments also include something called escrow, which is a mix of the mandatory real estate taxes and mandatory insurance that the bank requires that you keep during the life of the mortgage. Now, we already put this account in our chart of accounts, the principal. We already have a long-term liability in our chart of accounts that we put in an earlier video, and that reflects the current balance. What we have not yet put is interest expense and escrow in our chart of accounts, and we will put them both as an expense. Now you can see we already have mortgage to Mike in the chart of accounts at $70,000 from a previous video. This account is a long-term liability and it represents the principal balance that we owe on the mortgage. Now let's make the other two accounts. We click Accounting, Chart of Accounts, then we click New. Of course, this is an expense type of account. And they even have a detail type for interest expense, interest paid. Okay, it doesn't really matter the detail type in most cases, but we're going to put in capital letters, interest expense. Then click Save and Close. Good. Now click New. And of course, this one will be an expense, and this is the escrow. So again, the detail type doesn't matter, so you probably won't find one that says escrow. You could choose interest paid again because it's similar, even though it's not really interest, and we'll call this account escrow expense. And we click Save and Close. Now we have the accounts we need, and now we can do our example. So let's imagine on September 1, we made our first mortgage payment of $500. And let's imagine it's $100 for the escrow, $100 for the interest, and the principal balance will be reduced by $300. This is how you record that. You click the plus sign, go over to check, just like we did, and of course you put the date that you're paying, in this case, September 1. We are paying Mighty Mike's mortgages, okay? Just click no, we don't want to use the same amounts from before. Now, what category? Well, first we have the interest expense, and we already determined that was, in this example, $100. So we put $100. Okay, now we have the escrow, okay, which should be down here. Escrow expense, and we already determined in this example that's also $100. And of course the principal reduction will be recorded in the mortgage account, the long-term liability that we made and used in a previous video. That has a balance of $70,000, but now that we're paying $300 towards that, it will decrease it slightly. So the total that you're paying is $500, $100 is interest expense, $100 is escrow, and $300 decrease the principal balance. Now when we click Save and Close, we can click Reports, Trial Balance, and you can see right now, mortgage to Mike is no longer $70,000. It's $300 less because of this check. And you can see that interest expense and escrow expense have shown up for the first time as $100. Now let's reinforce this with a second example. Let's imagine in the next month, October 1, we made a second mortgage payment of $500. Of course, $100 is the escrow, but this time only $95 is the interest expense because the balance of the mortgage is lower and therefore the interest for this month is lower. So therefore, if we're paying $500 but only $95 in interest, this time the principal balance will decrease by $305. And that's the way we write the check. So we're going to click check. We're going to make the date October 1. Of course, it's Mighty Mike's mortgages that we're paying. Okay, click no for the previous. Now again, this time the interest expense is only $95. And of course, the escrow stays the same at $100. So therefore, the mortgage this time, which is the long-term liability, will go down by $305. Okay, that means the total is still $500. Now, when we click save and close, we go back to the trial balance and we can see now the mortgage has decreased by an additional $305, bringing it down to $69,395. And you can see that interest expense has gone up by $95 since last month, and the escrow reflects two months of payments. And that's how you record it. Now let's answer one last question. How do you know how much each payment goes to each part? Well, the bank will give you a payment schedule telling you how much of each payment is interest, how much of each payment is principal reduction and mortgage, and so on. You could also use the QuickBooks Loan Manager, which we'll show in the following videos, in order for you to double check the bank to make sure that the bank gave you the correct schedule of payments so that you know for sure how much of each of your mortgage payments is interest expense and how much is principal reduction. Unfortunately, the Loan Manager only goes with QuickBooks Windows Desktop, but you can still watch the videos and you can still watch the Excel video that will show you how to determine those amounts.